I'm always amazed at the bravery of Bay students, truly. You do things that I could have never and would have never done in high school. And so I want to pass it over to another brave, amazing student, a sophomore, Noah.
What?
Junior, sorry. All my years are off. Junior.
So a lot of everyone that knows me at Bay knows that I dance, but I think few of you actually like understand why like this is such a big part of my identity. Dance was my first love. When I was little, I was very quiet and shy. And then when my mom signed me up for dance, like I was relieved by how easy it was to express myself without words. And when I'm dancing, I feel like I can share the most vulnerable and fragile parts of myself. It's helped me discover my power, my resilience, my groove, and my joy. And we talk a lot about mindfulness at Bay, and for me, mindfulness is really pliés. For anyone who dances, or I think everyone just knows, hopefully, what a plié is. It's like... And then you continue on with the combination, but... You know, like, lately I've been feeling really burnt out from school, and I know, like, a lot of other people have too, but when I go to ODC, my dance studio, and I place my hand at the bar, I feel instantly re-energized. Ballet is so consuming physically, mentally, and emotionally, and it's really impossible to, like, think about anything, all the chaos from the outside world. And what I love about pliés is that it's, like, the moment in a ballet class before all the like technical rigor and the pirouettes and the jumps where you're just reminded to breathe and like reconnect to yourself. I like to say that like dancers are both athletes and artists because every day we work on our technique, but athleticism is not the goal. I view technique as more of a tool to clearly express my artistry. And so when I go through the plié combination at the start of each class, I'm not just warming up my muscles and my joints, but also my imagination and my passion, which you have to keep on fostering. And one of the biggest lessons dance has taught me is how to cope with cope and persevere from rejection. And over the years, I've gone through many auditions and have received many no's and some yeses. And the dance world is so competitive with the flood of talent. And it's really hard not to get up and get caught up in comparison because there's always going to be some girl who has like a sharper pirouette, a higher développé, just like a better jump. And it took me a long time to realize that just because you can't execute certain skills, it doesn't really reflect who you are as a person and your integrity as an artist. And like when I was younger, I auditioned 3 times for ODC's Velveteen Rabbit, and I cried each time. It was really hard as an 8-year-old. I don't know how old I was. Like getting a no is really, really sad. But each time I got back into it, and by the 3rd year, I got in. And I was, like, super excited. I was ready to learn all the choreography. It was just so cool because I performed in Yerba Buena Center for the Arts. And I was, which is, like, I think the biggest, like, performance venue except for, like, the opera in San Francisco. So it was really fun. I was kind of starstruck by being in the green room with... where all my favorite dance companies have been, like Batsheva and Alonzo King Lines Ballet, which Alonzo King Lines Ballet is from San Francisco. You should check them out. They're really cool. So I was, like, of course, I was a bit nervous. I was, like, performing in front of, like, hundreds, if not thousands of people. But as soon as I got on stage, I felt really comforted by, like, the lights and just, like, the people I was dancing with. And I just realized that like I really belong on stage. And then I think one of my most traumatic audition experience was, I think 4 years ago, I auditioned for the SF Ballet Summer Intensive, which SF Ballet is very classical. Let's just put it that way. Very traditional. And they said that there will be point. And these are point shoes. If anyone dances, these are Russian points. I love them. I was like, yeah, fine. I'm on point. I could do that. They did not mention that the whole class was going to be on point. And I did not yet have the technique to do point work in center. So that was like one of the most mortifying and embarrassing experiences of my life. And what made it worse was that my audition number placed me front and center in front of the audition panel. So I had to do the combination, not knowing what I was doing, in front of very judgy eyes. But not all my experiences have been bad with auditions. This January, I flew with my mom to LA for one day to audition for Alvin Ailey, which is like one of the top modern dance schools in the country. It's based in New York. And the style that they do there is Horton technique, which is a certain niche section of modern dance. And I was not familiar with that technique, but I just did my best. I went there, I showed up, and I got in, and I'm super excited. I'm going to New York for 3 weeks. And yeah, this just shows that like, even if you like don't know if you're really good enough, you should just show up and you might get in, because you really can, like you can have all the no's in the world, but you really only need one yes. And I think that's something that I learned. Also like thinking about, I plan to pursue dance after high school, and I know like I'll get a lot of rejections, but also some yeses for companies and college dance programs. So I think that's just like a good lesson to learn for life. And then we go, my last thing that I'm gonna talk about is that being accepted into the JAM, which is the teen modern dance company that I'm currently in. It has been one of the most meaningful experiences of my life. I've been dancing since I was 5, pretty much at the same studio, and it's such a great honor to, you know, be the oldest kids and like take on the role of a company member. And I've made some of like my best friends in the company, and it's so fun just like messing around with them in the studio before class and like, you know, just going through all of it together. It's definitely a lot, but it's definitely worth it. We train 5 days a week in ballet, contemporary, Pilates, and choreography. And we've also gotten to learn and work with the professional parent company, the ODC Dance Company. And those are like adults who like made it into a career. So it's really awesome. We're going to perform at their like 50th anniversary gala in Yerba Buena, which is like awesome. Yeah, like sometimes you have to like sacrifice some of your social life at school, or you can't like, you know, be on a sports team or like be in the play or, you know, always go to like the dances. I don't know, just like a normal high school experience. But I think for me, it's worth it because it's like who I am and it really carries me through life. So now I'm going to dance a bit for you. Keep in mind, this is something that's still in work of progress. Literally, I was just messing around yesterday, and this is what I came up with. And also, some of it will be improvised, meaning that some of it will be just made up on the spot.
There I was in uniform, looking at Museum. He asked us what our my favorite work of art was, and never could I tell him it was him. So I wish I could tell him. Oh, I wish I could have told.
Thank you so much. Next slide, please. It's really fun to improv, guys. You should like get back into it, even if it's just like in your bedroom. It's really fun. Just like put on some like emotional music, or I don't know, whatever music you like, and just like dance. And then this is why I came to talk today. So, as I mentioned, I'm in a teen dance company, the ODC Dance Jam. Sorry, just catch my breath. And our home season is coming up. We've been working all year, dedicated like so many hours. Our show is called Unhinged. It's a self-produced performance featuring the works of four renowned choreographers. And the work expresses like the distress of instability and the power of community to heal. All the pieces are really different, so I'm sure there's like something for everyone. Also, we had a really cool photo shoot, so, and we designed the flyer, we designed the program. I'm in charge of PR, so I've already written to SF Chronicle, other things, so it's all like us that's producing it. And so I really want you guys to all come out and support us. There are three shows, Saturday, April 9th at 8 p.m., and Saturday, April 10th at 4 p.m. and 7 p.m. Tickets are sliding scale from $15. And if you need any like financial help, please like talk to me. We could figure it out together. I just want all of you guys to come. And so the show's at ODC Dance Commons, which is in the Mission, and I'll send out tickets in the current. Thanks so much.
Noah, thank you. I'm actually speechless. That was simply incredible. I just really appreciate it amongst many things. Like, I don't know about you, I could feel your energy and your sense of clarity about what matters and how you've brought that to life. Let's do one more round of applause. That was amazing.